Well, hello there, motherfuckers. And it appears to me that Rusev might have been released. So I put out my WWE news just as I'm about to put it up late last night. I see that the match has been changed, but I was like, you know what? Fuck it. I'm going to put it up anyway. But here's an update. Jericho has been moved into the slot for the greatest Royal Rumble super card, super show, pay-per-view, if you could even call them that anymore, that's coming up in Saudi Arabia that will be aired on the network. So, you know, I actually rather see Jericho versus Undertaker. Now, people might say, okay, well, Rusev's a bigger guy, so maybe that'd be a bigger matchup. But, of course, you know, the Smarks are going to be happier, and I'm even happier. I want to see this match. We haven't seen Jericho Undertaker too many times in WWE, so it's cool to get to see this in a casket match. Pretty obvious Jericho's going to lose here. But Rusev also, you know, I don't know, some of the things he was writing were pretty pathetic. He put, bury me gently, brother, like he knew he was going to job. That didn't really sound like something WWE would tell him to tweet. I realize that sometimes probably WWE tells them to tweet sometimes, and just like a lot of popular celebrities, they might have people that they might suggest what to tweet for them. Probably, I don't know so much anymore, because I don't think it's back like in the old days when these wrestlers, would probably have like outside help. You know, now they're just getting everything funneled in through creative and telling them what to do. So whatever the case may be, this is probably what he really tweeted. Bury me gently. Now then he said that I'm going to, you know, crush his old ass. And Michelle McCool had retweeted, which I don't like that, by the way. Because if Undertaker is not going to be the American badass and he's going to be, you know, the really fictional, you know, it's already fictional, but even more fictional, Dark Side Undertaker, I'd rather not have Michelle McCool in the picture. But, you know, it's the age of Twitter, it's the age of social media, so that shit went out the window a long time ago. Kayfabe went out the window. I mean, this guy is striking down lightning bolts, and his wife is like, don't go there, you know? I mean, it kind of just doesn't add up. It doesn't look good, you know? But anyway, he removed like all the WWE references from his Twitter, and then he posted, well, it will be Rusev Day again somewhere. So if you're removing all the references, I don't know, is his profile still up on WWE.com? That's usually one of the telltale signs. So I don't know, guys. You know, the thing is, I never heard any reports or anything. I mean, you can't go by the dirt sheets, but I don't think Rusev ever did anything really wrong. I mean, this guy has done job after job. You know, he lost in like 10 seconds to Randy Orton, at SummerSlam last year. This guy continuously looks bad. The crowd is cheering for him. They're cheering Rusev Day. They want to see Rusev get a push. They want to see him do good. And, you know, like I said, I'm always like, don't listen to the crowd. Don't play the house. That's the worst move they can make. That's the reason why we wound up with AJ versus Nakamura Murphy, for God's sakes. But aside from that, Rusev Day seems to be taking off. I don't know what the merch sales are, but I don't know. They officially killed it. They're taking him off. I guess the guy might have asked for his release. If I were Rusev, I would be getting tired of this nonsense. You know, the thing is, it's been proven that out there on the indies, these wrestlers sometimes make more money. So I don't know how much Rusev is making right now, but if he could take the Rusev Day shtick on the road, that is if it's not trademarked, because if it's trademarked, then he's fucked. Then I don't really see how that's going to even really matter. But if it's not trademarked, then he could really take it on the road, and it could actually end up being a successful gig for him. I mean, you see these guys like Austin Aries and the rest of them, and maybe even like the Hurricane, for example. I think these guys are making more money on the indies doing their own thing. So, you know, so if it's not trademark, it probably is. He could probably do more, but I don't know for sure. I don't know if you guys read any stories about this. Let me know in the comments. Is Rusev really been released? This is a bit of a weird story. It was like a last minute change. Anyway, guys, there's your little update. It's been your YWC champ, signing out.